Welcome to the 14th lecture on calculus. Today we will discuss positive series. So these are series of positive real numbers. So that means these are series whose terms are positive real numbers. So first we will define what is positive series. We will study its convergence and divergence, and at the end we will see what is absolutely convergent series. And we will prove that if a series is absolutely convergent, then it is actually a convergent series. So here is the definition of series of positive real numbers, positive series. So a series is called a series of positive real numbers if its term is positive. And next we will discuss about convergence and divergence of this positive series. So this theorem states that if consider a series of positive real numbers, that means every term is positive real number for this series, then this series is convergent if and only if the sequence of partial sums it is bounded above. So it is enough to study this sequence of partial sums, and it is enough to prove that this sequence of partial sums it is bounded above. Let's prove this theorem. So you consider this series of positive real numbers, then the sequence of partial sums it is monotone increasing. Why? Because Sn it is just x1 plus x2 plus up to xn, and what is Sn plus 1? It is just Sn plus xn plus 1. So you are adding some extra term to Sn to get Sn plus 1, and this extra term it is some positive real number. So you can clearly see that Sn it is less than Sn plus 1 for all n. Okay, so this is strictly increasing sequence. By the theory of monotone sequence, so that is lecture 7, we have that this sequence is convergent if and only if this sequence is bounded above. So to prove this implication, so this implication is always true. Every convergent sequence is bounded sequence, and hence in particular it is bounded above sequence. So if a sequence is convergent, then that implies that it is bounded above sequence. Now what about converse? So to prove the converse, you need this fact. So since it is monotone increasing, so this sequence it is bounded below sequence, and if you have this extra condition that this sequence is bounded above, so therefore this sequence is a bounded sequence, and every monotone bounded sequence is convergent, that we have proved in lecture 7. So we have this implication, and for this implication you can see lecture 4. So every convergent sequence is bounded, and hence it is bounded above sequence. Okay, so this series of positive real numbers, it is convergent by definition. It is equivalent to say that this sequence of partial sums it is convergent, and since it is monotone increasing, so this statement it is equivalent to say that this is bounded above sequence. So we have this theorem. And next we will study two examples. Okay, so you consider this series whose nth term is given by this. So this is a series of positive real numbers. In lecture 11 we have proved that this series it is a convergent series. Let's argue in a different way. So this is a series of positive real numbers, and whatever theorem we just proved, using that we can argue that this series is convergent. Okay, so you consider again the nth partial sum. So we will consider this sequence of partial sums. This s sub n, this is the sum of the first n terms. So this is just this one, and that observation, this term you can write as 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. So if you write each term in this way, so you can cancel out all the terms except the first term of this and the last term of this. So ultimately you will get that this summation it is same as 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. So this sequence of partial sums it is given by this. So nth term it is given by this, and of course it is bounded. Therefore, by the theorem it follows that this series is convergent, because this is a series of positive real numbers such that this sequence of partial sums it is bounded above, and therefore this is a convergent sequence. And here is another example. So you consider this geometric series, and in lecture 13, in the previous lecture, we have proved that this series, geometric series, is convergent if and only if this R it satisfies this condition. So this series is convergent if and only if absolute value of R it is less than 1. So let's give another argument just using the theory what we have proved in today's class. But we will prove that this is convergent if and only if R is less than 1 for this case only, because we want to use the theory of series of positive real numbers. So you consider R is some positive real number. In that case, this is a series of positive real numbers. Okay. So then one can consider the nth partial sum S sub n, and this Sn it is given by the sum of the first n terms of the series. And if R is not equal to 1, then this sum it is given by this value. And from this observation, we can see the sequence Sn is bounded above if and only if the absolute value of R is less than 1. So since we are considering positive real number, and one can clearly see that if R is greater than or equal to 1, so suppose R is 1, so you consider this case separately, R is 1. So in that case, you can see that S sub n, it is just sum of 1 n times. So in this case, it is just n. So in this case, this sequence, it is not bounded above sequence. And if R is greater than 1, then also one can prove that this sum Sn, it is 1 minus r power n, 1 minus r. So one can write it r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. So in this case also, this term r power n, this is not bounded above. So it is not bounded. Okay. So this sequence of partial sums, it is bounded above if and only if r is less than 1. And therefore, for positive real number R, by the theorem discussed today, it follows that this geometric series, it is convergent if and only if R is less than 1. So at least using the theory of series of positive real numbers, we can prove that for positive real number R, this geometric series is convergent if and only if R is less than 1. And next we will discuss absolutely convergent series. So what is absolutely convergent series? A series that is summation x sub n, this series is called an absolutely convergent series if the series of absolute values, that is the series whose nth term is given by this absolute value of the nth terms of this series. So this series is called an absolutely convergent series if the series of absolute values converges. So if this series is convergent, then we call that this series, it is an absolutely convergent series. And here is the theorem about this absolutely convergent series. So it says that if a series is absolutely convergent, then that implies that that series is convergent. So how to prove that? We can use Cauchy's criterion for a series to be convergent. We know that a series is convergent if and only if it satisfies Cauchy's criterion. Okay, what is Cauchy's criterion? So for every epsilon, there should be some natural number, there should be some stage, so that after that stage, the sum of any number of consecutive terms, that absolute value of that should be less than epsilon. So it is given that this series is absolutely convergent series. So that is, this series of absolute values, this is a convergent series, and therefore it satisfies Cauchy's criterion. And therefore, for this epsilon, there exists a natural number n such that beyond that natural number, the absolute value of the sum of any number of consecutive terms of this series that is less than epsilon. So we have this condition. So we know that a plus b that is less than or equal to mod a plus mod b for any two real numbers a and b. So using this inequality you can have this, and since this sum it is less than epsilon for all m greater than n greater than this big n. So and we have this inequality, so ultimately we are getting that this thing it is less than epsilon for all natural numbers m greater than n greater than this big n. So ultimately we are proving that this series it is satisfying Cauchy's criterion. So therefore this series is convergent. And what about the converse of this theorem? The converse to this theorem, it is not true in general. That is, a convergent series need not be an absolutely convergent series. So what I mean that you can have an example of a series which is a convergent series but it is not absolutely convergent series. For example, you can consider this series. This series is a convergent series, that is I will leave this thing as exercise. I will put this thing in assignment 2 and I will give enough hints to prove this, that this series it is convergent series. So this is a convergent series but it is not absolutely convergent series. Why? Because the series of the absolute values of this series it is just this one, and we call it harmonic series. So it is a sum of 1 by n, n varies from 1 to infinity. So this is this infinite sum, and this series is not convergent. That we have proved in the first lecture on series of lecture 11. So this is a series which is a convergent series but it is not absolutely convergent series. And that's all. I will stop now.